Uganda's quest for strong industrial growth and development is on an upward trajectory. Latest data shows that Uganda has over 5,000 operational industries in various sectors. Jinja remains Uganda's industrial hub with over 100 industries, more than double the number of industries it had back then. During the launch of the Sustainable Water Quality Management Project recently at the Ministry of Water and Environment, it was revealed that the nature of pollution has evolved due to the developing nature of the country.
We'll be changing in character from the simple pollution of organic to more complex chemical pollution from industries. As Uganda is modernizing through agro-industry, we also encourage through our Vision 2040.
Lilian Idrakua, the Commissioner for Water Quality Management at the Ministry of Water and Environment, says that human developments like agriculture activities and industrialization have resulted in siltation of water bodies and environmental degradation, thereby affecting climate.
The sense of pollution that comes like collectively. In science, we talk about point and non-point source pollution. The point source pollution is the type of pollution where the you can identify and see pollution is coming from a certain place.
Some schools have since been phased out due to flooding. Joseph Chiimba reveals that after the phasing out of St. James Church of Uganda Primary School in Waise in 2012 due to floods, he was transferred to Kawempe Church of Uganda Primary School. Against his former experience, Chiimba endeavored to make a difference in conserving the environment at his new school, which was as well affected by severe soil erosion.
My being a hardworking person and being creative, I tried my best with my children to see that at least we put this school in a good state, the way how it is looking like in terms of environment, looking after the green, looking after the plants and what have you.
With developments such as urban farming, Chiimba has been able to create vivid differences, inspiring and encouraging other people.
When it comes to urban farming, these sacks that are being thrown almost everywhere, whichever trench that you pass through within the city, you find that there are garbages, there is garbage which is being put in a way that people just drop wherever they wish. So for us, we pick them and put them into good use.
What we've done also has contributed to the diet for both the children and the teachers. Children, first of all, have learned to grow the trees, and some of these trees have been named, names chosen by the children. They have learned to take care of the trees, meaning they have come to learn caring about the environment.
Despite visible industrial developments across the country, the government has been asked to streamline control measures of investors in a bid to not only cater for people's economic growth, but also ensure a favorable climate trend.
They need actually to put task some of these investors who come, because they come. You can look at, for example, right now, many of them who come, they set up these smaller-scale industries and whatever, and factories in wetlands.
It should be noted that during this year's inaugural Africa Climate Summit hosted in Nairobi, Kenya, in September, Uganda committed to work towards accelerating efforts to reduce greenhouse emissions, aligned with goals set forth in the Paris Agreement, which calls on parties to make finance flows consistent with a pathway towards low greenhouse gas emissions and climate-resilient developments. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.